So substitute this in equation 1, we get sin theta naught equal to n1 by n naught root of 1 minus n2 square by n1 square. Here it is the equation 1. If we substitute here, we get this one, sin theta naught equal to n1 by n naught root of 1 minus n2 square by n1 square. Okay, from this, sin theta naught equal to n1 by n naught root of n1 square minus n2 square by n1 square. Here root n1 square and n1 both are cancelled. After that, sin theta naught equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square by n naught. Actually, it is the acceptance angle theta naught. So this theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square by n0. It is the actual formula. But here, what is n0? n0 is refractive index of air. For air, refractive index is 1. Okay, then theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. Generally, we use this formula only. Theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. Here, n1 is refractive index of core, n2 is refractive index of cladding. This is the equation for acceptance angle. Okay, so here, what is acceptance angle? It is the maximum angle of incidence at end face of the core to produce total internal reflection. What is the formula here? Theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. Okay. Next, we discuss numerical aperture. Okay. Here, numerical aperture, it represents the light gathering capacity of the optical fiber. Okay. So, here, it represents how much light is gathered by the fiber. Okay. So, numerical aperture represents the light gathering capacity of an optical fiber. So, it is defined as numerical aperture. It can be represented by simply sine of acceptance angle. So, it is the numerical aperture that is equal to sine of, it is the acceptance angle. Already we know that what is acceptance angle? Sine inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. So, numerical aperture equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. It is the formula here. So, acceptance angle formula is theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. Numerical aperture formula, na equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. So, next we discuss fractional change in refractive index. Okay. So, fractional change in refractive index we indicate with delta here. So, how we define? It is the ratio between the difference in refractive indices of core and cladding to the refractive index of core. Okay. So, here it is the fractional change in refractive index delta equal to n1 minus n2 by n1. So, then n1 minus n2 equal to delta n1. We know the formula of numerical aperture. What is numerical aperture? Na equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. Okay. So, it is in the form of a square minus b square, means a plus b into a minus b. Okay, so here na equal to root of n1 plus n2 into n1 minus n2. What is n1 minus n2? N1 minus n2 is delta n1. If we substitute here, so here na equal to root of n1 plus n2 into delta n1. So here n1 is refractive index of core, n2 is refractive index of cladding. Both are N1 is slightly greater than N2, but both are approximately equal. That's why N1 is approximately equal to N2. So, we can write like this, N1 plus N2 is approximately equal to 2N1. So, Na equal to root of 2N1 delta N1. And one more equation for numerical aperture, Na equal to N1 root 2 delta. Okay, these are the formulas. First formula, numerical aperture theta naught equal to sin inverse root of n1 square minus n2 square. Next formula, numerical aperture na equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. And fractional change in refractive index delta equal to n1 minus n2 by n1. And one more formula, numerical aperture, one more formula, na equal to n1 root 2 delta.